very, very proud of the kids today. Obviously, last weekend, and that loss was tough. We had a lot of things go on last week, other than a football game, and very, very proud of how, once again, our kids are resilient, and they come to work every single day and coming on out. And this is a good football team that we just played today. Very, very sound, very, very technically where they need to be, as you can see there. And we came up with big plays that you don't happen to have in all those things. I think the turnovers, I can't see because of my glasses, but I don't think we had a turnover today, so that's why you win football games. You keep the ball, you're going to win football games. And if we ever could find a running back to run the ball, then we'll be a decent football team. I'm not sure what we're going to do, but if we ever could find a running back to do that, and some guys on the defensive line and put a little pressure on the quarterback. We're proud of all the kids. We did some things today. We'll walk back tomorrow and say, great job. And our thought process coming to next week, we know, and I believe we do not have playoffs, but this is our playoffs, okay? You win one. So, again, at the end of the game, okay, one more to go. Got to win. Got to be 1-0 next week. That's all our eyes are right now. Is fixated on going up there to Harvard and taking care of business. It's great to win on homecoming weekend. Get a chance to celebrate. Five different championship teams are here, and it's so great to see all those guys and great memories. So excited for everybody, and we'll enjoy this for maybe 12 hours, and then we'll jump right back into. Well, at least I will. 12 hours. You guys can enjoy it a little bit longer.
All right, we'll take questions for Malachi and Joey.
Go ahead. For Joey, just kind of that goal line stand that you had, you had a first and goal at the two, and then you stopped with four straight plays. I was wondering, can you walk me through that, and how great is it for defense to kind of get that turning point and hold them there?
Yeah, I mean, we practice that a lot. Pretty much every week, we practice our goal line package, and we got the guys to do it. We have a motto on the defense called "More Ammo." It goes back to the Marines. Coach Benson is a big Marines person, and he echoes that to us every week. And the goal line stand is kind of the epitome of that. We practice that every week, and we trust our guys when we have that personnel in there. And I'm just grateful we got the stop.
So all week, coaches challenged us to run the ball because we ran the ball against them well last year. So just with us taking that like to a heart, because we didn't really run the ball well last week. So that was just like more fire, and then we decided we was going to run it this week. And we did. We executed the plan that coach had set for us.
Also, if you, Malachi, I just want to ask specifically, your 96-yard run today was the longest offensive play in Penn history. I don't know the exact rushing yard total, but it's like the third most rushing yard in the game in Penn history. I just wanted to ask, obviously for you individually, a record like that has to be cool, but how does that feel in the context of, helping the team get the win?
Accolades feel good and all, but just getting the team alone was better. And job's not finished. We got two more, and then after that, we got that ring.
Yes, sir. Well said.
Any more questions for Malachi and Joey?
Malachi, you just talked a little about your season trajectory. You're starting out, you can see some action early on, and now you're the lead back in all these carries. What's that been like, stepping into that role?
Well, in the summer, I just wanted to come in, learn the playbook, help as best as I could. And I just took it day by day. I stayed humble and hungry. And then more chances and opportunities came knocking. I just opened the door.
Yeah, can you talk a little about that 96-yard run? You kind of, went straight up the middle, then you bounced to the outside and bounced back in. What did you see there? What were you?
So when I got the ball, I was patient. And as I got it, I just seen everything get washed. So then I was able to bounce it. And then I just ran straight. And then I looked up the jumbo trying to see the last dude. And that's how I got him.
Did you really?
Yes, I looked at the screen.
Any more questions for the guys? Awesome. Thanks, guys. You guys can go.
Thank you.
All right, we'll take questions for Coach P.
Coach, so Jaden Key had that interception late. I think he may have played a couple snaps last week, but he was out there a bit more today. I was wondering if you could talk a bit more about how great it is that he's working his way back and being able to make an impact on the defense.
Absolutely. I think you win late games if you can stay healthy as a football team. Okay, and obviously when he went down at the Georgetown game, we all that impacted, right? You see one of your brothers down there about moving. Thankfully, he got all his tests and he came back and I was able to perform today. And what a phenomenal play that was! He came out of nowhere and he does what he does. He can cover ground, and it's great to have him back. But Julian Talley has done a great job filling him, and Shiloh, those combination of guys have really done a real good job. And just proud of all the guys playing really good team football today. But kids, let's remember this. We were sitting here, you know, last Friday, talking about one or two or three plays. And that's what the game football is all about. You got to make, you don't know when those important plays are going to be, okay? But we made those couple plays today, with explosive plays. So very proud of the team. So.
Obviously, just wanted to get your perspective, Coach, on Malachi's performance today, especially, you know, those really big explosive runs. I mean, how is that, you know, beneficial for you as a coach to know someone, I know you have someone that can, you know, make those explosive plays, and how did it really, you know, factor in today?
Yeah, he's especially a talented young man. There's a little adage I heard one time. If you have to teach a dog how to bite, you got the wrong dog. If you got to teach a running back how to run, you got the wrong running back. It's all instincts. He really just has natural instincts, sees things, okay, and he's got God-giving talent and speed, okay, so whoever asked that question earlier, he was right. He was running inside zone to the right. They collapsed everything. He's got the patience and the giddy up and go that he can do that. Not everybody has to build that 0 to 20 to get outside of those guys and take the distance. And that's a gift. He is so gifted. And it's a couple weeks ago he was in here. He's the most humble young man that is out there. A really special young man, very special.
I also wanted to ask about, you know, you mentioned earlier, you know, no turnovers today. It just felt like a really complete effort on both sides of the ball, which I feel like the team has been building for through this whole season. Does any perspective on really putting it all together today?
Yeah, I think what happens, okay, you know, it's not from the neck down. It's not the physical part per se. It's just from the mental part. And I just think it's a focus. And sometimes, two things. One is you make a bad play, and sometimes what we don't do, we don't give the opponent that much credit. Now that corner from Brown made a terrific play in the end zone, and the other safety made a terrific play. I mean, Aiden threw the ball where it needed to be and made a terrific. So you gotta give the other guys credit sometimes too, right? I mean, we wanna be disappointed with loss and that stuff. But I just look at this as a season. We're getting better as the year's gone along. We stubbed our toe a little bit last Friday night, but that's okay. We know it. We just gotta win one. Just one more. That's all it is. One more, that's been our motto the whole entire year, and we continue that drive down the home stretch here.
I think Coach Stan only threw it 13 times today.
Sure.
Fewest all season is 35.
Sure.
And I was just wondering how great it is to have like a balanced offense, not rely on him all the time, but he can make the plays, but to not have like sure. 40, 50 times a game.
Here's what I give the credit to, okay? Our offensive coordinator, Dan Swanstrom, and the offensive staff, okay? What they do is strategize what is the best way to win games, not to get stats, okay? So what they did today was they found the breakdown in their running attack and their approach, because they take away a lot of big things on you, okay? And then we were able to run the ball. Well, if you want the craziest stat, I got on my glass here. What was the time of possession today? Where were they, time of possession?
I think they had a lot more.
Yeah, with no joke. What was the minutes? How many minutes?
37. 37
for Cornell, 22, 13. I mean, their offense, they are so well structured, okay, to get the game and try to win the fourth quarter. They're like an NFL-style offense. They huddle, break the huddle, slow play, quarterback under center is done strategically to shorten the game. They are plus 10 minutes on every opponent this year at time of possession. Okay? That is huge, so you can't have the turnovers there. However, and in their offensive approach, okay, is to take away the bubbles, the quick passes, which we do a lot of, if you haven't noticed, okay, and they were able to take that away. We saw it on a film, so we went to it and we said, let's build a great run game. And our offensive staff did a tremendous job. And the offensive line, let's give those boys credit, because you don't make those runs without having some real good world that way.
Coach, two games left. You got Harvard next week. You control your own destiny for a share of the Ivy title. What's your message to the team?
1-0. Be 1-0, okay? And the thing we talk about, I heard this from the past great wide receiver, who the guy Justin Watson. I'm not sure if you guys know the guy Watson. He had a great phrase. I'm not sure where he got it, but someone's put me in a book today. One of the alums, be where your feet are. Okay, we control what we control here. Okay, I told the guys, have a safe Saturday night, have a really good Sunday, be where your feet are. Okay, you can't be doing things down the road. We got to take it step by step. This is a process. Trust that process, okay? And let's take it step by step. And when your time and your number is called, come out and be ready to play. So one of my former teammates brought the players brought that for me today.
Coach, is there any update on the status of Jerry Richardson?
Yeah, I'm being really, really transparent. I'm not sure what it was, other than it was this more of a stinger that he really just didn't feel up to it. And yeah, what a great play that you could turn around and put the best receiver in the league on the bench and give him a day off and play the other kid. So we're very fortunate for that. But knowing him, he was chomping to try to get back in. So he'll be back and ready.
Any more questions for Coach? Awesome. Thanks.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate you.
See you next week at Harvard.